Hi, I'm Lisa Prather, and welcome to The Voice of Health with our host, Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice, where lives are changed every day through the natural approach to healthcare. Today, our show is about the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, one of the most important things we do at the Prather Practice. And Dr. Prather, what exactly is the Atlas Orthogonal?
The Atlas, well, it helps to be sort of self-explanatory in the name.
Uh-huh.
The atlas bone is the top vertebrae in the spine. It sits right underneath the skull and holds up the head, so therefore it's a little tiny thing, and holds up this big head, so they decided
Who's
to call it
head?
The atlas. big head.
Yeah.
Well, the head weighs about as much as a bowling ball.
Really?
So it's in the atlas, if you take it off, you know, well, I've actually held atlases, real human atlases in my hand, and with it dried, you can actually blow it off of your
it's
hand.
That light.
It's that light.
Mm-hmm.
So it's holding up the skull, it's the top vertebrae, and it's also at one of the most critical areas of your body. The lower brainstem, which controls the autonomic nervous system, which controls all the functioning of your body that's not under conscious control.
Mm.
So
it's a very important.
Very, very important type of area. Matter of fact, when I first got into chiropractic, I asked people, the different chiropractors that I respected, what is the most important adjustment in the body?
Mm-hmm.
And it was 100% in agreement that the atlas was. It was the most important area to be working on. And I said, what is the most difficult adjustment? And they said, the atlas.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a freely movable joint. It will rotate. It will. There is some sliding back and forth. So it's a very light type of a skeletal structure. It has a very critical area and is extremely important and the most difficult adjustment. So I said, well, who is the best at adjusting that?
Mm-hmm.
And everyone was in agreement that it was Dr. Roy Sweat down in Atlanta, Georgia. So one of the things I decided to do was to learn from him.
Mm-hmm.
And he was the developer of the Atlas Orthogonal Technique.
Okay. So that's how you got involved.
Right. And then the orthogonal, that means at right angles. So what we're looking at is that the atlas needs to go in a straight line to gravity.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then the head, the center of the head needs to be directly above it, and then the cervical spine needs to be directly below. That's why it's so critical, you know, is to bring that body back into a structural homeostasis.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a perfect position for that atlas to be at in relationship to that skull and cervical spine, and that's the basis of the Atlas Orthogonal program.
Interesting. And tell us about the effect it had on your health. I know that's how you got involved too. Is it was very helpful for your health.
Yes, I went to a chiropractor. One, I had developed Graves' disease, and it's a hyperthyroid situation, which also developed some parathyroid problems and led to a whole host of health issues for me.
Mm-hmm.
The solution that the medical system wanted to do for my condition was surgery.
Mm-hmm.
to remove part of the thyroid and parathyroid. But it would still have some long-term types of consequences.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the body regulation. So that really didn't seem as a legitimate type of a solution for me, and certainly not something that brought me back into normal health. So I was on a quest to find the answers to my own health issues. And the most important thing that I found was that adjustment.
Mm-hmm.
And I had someone who was trained by Dr. Sweat, who adjusted me, and I got immediate changes. I had had the condition for 4 years. I was 20 years old by that time. And I was weighing 145 pounds, and I've got pretty big structure. And as soon, after I got the adjustment, I went into a very deep sleep. I felt completely different afterwards. And within 3 months, I had gone from 145 pounds up to 200 pounds. And I had actually grown an inch. And since I had started the condition, I hadn't grown at all.
Yeah, so someone listening would say, how could a procedure like that have such an effect? You know, and what you said, you went into a deep sleep. What does that mean?
Well, interestingly enough, after the adjustment, they took me in and laid me down to rest. And I fell asleep before I even hit the pillow. As a matter of fact, a lot of the patients, yesterday I had a patient say, after my adjustment, I went home and took a two-hour nap. Is that normal?
Right.
You know, because I was just, you know, just ready to sleep. And absolutely, that's when the body heals itself, is during that sleep cycle. And I fell asleep, and I felt that they woke me up as soon as my head hits the pillow. Matter of fact, I said, why did you guys wake me up? I just laid down. And everybody laughed because I had laid there for 4 hours.
Wow.
And
is that the nervous system settling down?
That is the nervous system readjusting itself. You know, being able to go into a healing process is what sleep is involved with. So it, I could feel energy go from my neck all the way down to my feet and back up again. And there was a whole shifting of the nervous system. And the nervous system, there's two systems that you that tells the whole rest of the body what to do, and they're very integrated. There's a tremendous amount of communication between them. Some people even consider them one system. Is the nervous system and the endocrine system. And if those two things aren't right, then the you know, the rest of the body is just not going to work correctly. Because it's the command center.
Right.
You know, if you don't have the communication going on, the what's telling the body what to do, you can fix everything else, and everything else will go right back to where it was because of the communication system. So the nervous system and the endocrine system are absolutely critical, and the Atlas Orthogonal is dealing with the most important part of the nervous system. That autonomic nervous system tells the endocrine system and the whole rest of the nervous system what to do. So if that's not correct, then there's a definite problem.
Yeah. So it's a very powerful, and I know you take x-rays for this adjustment, correct, and analyze them?
Correct.
It's very specific.
Yes, the x-rays are critical because you have to see what type of a pattern. The basis of the Atlas Orthogonal system is based on mathematics. The beginning of the system was actually started with B.J. Palmer. He was the one that said that the Atlas was the most critical area.
And he's the founder of chiropractic, correct?
D.D. Palmer is.
Okay.
And then B.J. Palmer was the son who got the schools going. And was one of the founders of the chiropractic system. So he found that the Atlas was what he felt was the most important adjustment. He had decided on that and had developed a technique along those lines to make it, to improve it. And then that was followed up by Dr. Grostick in Michigan, who did quite a few of pre and post x-rays and found that that there was actually even more of an analysis that could be done, and started to get into the mathematics of the alignment of the cervical spine. So he did a tremendous amount of work along those lines to help to develop it, and develop something called the Grostick technique. The Grostick technique was used, and it was done by hand, and it was a very, very difficult type of a adjustment to do. Most of the people who tried to learn how to do it weren't physically capable of actually doing the adjustment, mm-hmm. because it was so demanding on the system. Matter of fact, I had learned how to do the hand adjustment before I got into the instrument, mm-hmm. and I was able to do it, but it was very taxing on the body. So Dr. Sweat was the first one who was certified to teach the Grostic technique under Dr. Grostic.
Okay.
So he was the leading person under that, and felt that going to an instrument type of an adjustment would be something that would help to advance the technique.
Mm-hmm.
One, it could be much more consistent because you don't have the variabilities in the body.
Yeah, it's very precise.
Very precise. And then it's very mathematical, so you could get it down to within 2 millimeters of setting up the instrument,
mm-hmm.
to make the adjustment. So he went ahead and advanced that. And while I was interning with him is when he finalized the Atlas Orthogonal technique and system. Matter of fact, I was in the very first 6 students to be trained in the Atlas Orthogonal technique.
Mm-hmm. That was a long time ago.
That was... Well, you don't have to say it quite like that. To me, it wasn't that long ago,
right.
But 35
like
years, I guess.
Right?
Yes, right.
All right. Well, up next, let's talk about Montel Williams and his association with the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment.
You can win a free 60-minute massage in a relaxing spa at the Prather Practice. Each month, we have a drawing to give away a free massage to one of our lucky Facebook and Twitter fans. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. This is The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. The Voice of Health Wellness Tip with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice.
Dr. Prather, you talk a lot about structure function care and disease care. What is the difference between the two?
When you're talking about disease care, you're usually talking about an interference in the body's normal mechanisms. There is a time for that. When the body is actually in a process of free fall, is a good way to kind of put it, where the body is no longer making sense of what it's doing. And we're on a pattern that it will actually crash. Then you need some interference. And the best way to actually do that is through pharmaceuticals. Pharmaceuticals are classified as poisons. They actually take the body further away from homeostasis, which I'll define here in a second.
Mm-hmm.
But at those times, that is actually necessary. So when the body is in a crisis and is no longer able to heal itself, that's when disease care is actually critical. That's where you actually utilize the pharmaceuticals and the surgical methods. What we're usually involved with is in structure function, and as opposed to a disease care, it's health care. Everything that you use in a structure function standpoint is something to bring the body back into homeostasis, which is balance.
Okay.
Dr. Guyton talked about homeostasis as the definition of health. If the body can maintain homeostasis, where it's in a perfect balance with all the different types of things that are coming in that are interfering with its function, that is the perfect state of health, and that's based on a balance of the physiology, functional, and upon the structure portion of the structure function.
Well, you talk about the body as the hero. What do you mean by that?
Body has a self-healing mechanism to it that can just make all sorts of corrections if we can just get out of its way. The whole idea behind healthcare is to provide the impetus, the needs, and the basis of what it will take to actually get the body well. Finding out where it's off, doing the proper diagnostics, and then making the proper type of adjustments into the care will actually result in the healing and the position that the body should actually be in.
Well, find out how structure function care can impact your life.
Schedule your appointment at the Prather Practice, 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. The Prather Practice, restoring hope.
I feel good. I knew that I would not. So good, so good. I got you. Oh,
you're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of The Prather Practice, the most comprehensive wellness center in the Midwest. Our focus today is on the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment that we do at the Prather Practice. And Dr. Prather, we talked a little bit about your training, but before that, I want, on your website, on our website, we have a video of Montel Williams. And what is that, you know, all about? I know he had suffered from multiple sclerosis and got involved with the Atlas Orthogonal technique as a patient. Mm-hmm. Do you want to elaborate on that?
Yes, Montel Williams had been suffering with multiple sclerosis and had tried a lot of different types of treatments to help with that, and had been recommended to someone who did the Atlas Orthogonal program. And as he said, it was the most significant treatment with the best results of anything he's ever done.
Mm-hmm.
He said he could tell an immediate difference. It reduces his discomfort, a tremendous amount of his symptoms. And whenever he does go out of place on his atlas, he knows it immediately.
Mm-hmm.
By his symptomatology, goes in, gets an adjustment, and the overall effects of the multiple sclerosis are greatly reduced.
So how does the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment help MS?
The multiple sclerosis is a neurological disease. It is scar tissue that actually forms on the spinal cord with inflammatory results. And when you do the adjustment, there is a reduction in the torque in the spinal cord.
Okay.
So there is a dramatic changes that occur. As I'm doing analysis for the to do the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, there are a couple things that I'm looking for. One is there are peripheral nerve problems going on. Mm-hmm. There are definite ways that I can determine that. One, you get a very sore neck.
Mm-hmm.
There are nerve tracings that we can do. There's weakness that occurs. If you do nerve studies, then there is a definite change that occurs on the peripheral nerve system and what's going on. But we also evaluate the effects on the spinal cord.
Okay.
And usually both of those things are involved with an atlas subluxation. So the main thing is the effect on the spinal cord that makes such a difference with the multiple sclerosis, because there are actually connections to the spinal cord, to the vertebrae, and if there's a twisting, if there's a misalignment, there's an increased tension on there, and there are definite changes in the conduction of the spinal cord when that occurs. So when you get that straight and there isn't any torsion, tension on the spinal cord, there is a relief of the pressure, and there's a reduction of the symptoms of the multiple sclerosis that occurs with that.
Mm. So what conditions does the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment help? You talked, you know, here about MS.
Certainly. Any type of nerve problems, any types of peripheral nerve problems, looking towards the atlas will be a very important type of way to work with that. Any type of central nervous system issues.
Mm-hmm.
We get good results with multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's, ALS, all those different types of conditions. There was a recent study done from a friend of mine who was sponsored by the University of Chicago, where they did studies on hypertension,
mm-hmm.
blood pressure. And with the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, keeping that in place had a greater effect on blood pressure than medication.
Wow. So what about neck pain?
Yeah, definitely.
Does it help?
Headaches, migraines. We have very strong changes in ADD, ADHD. Very important to get that balanced out. We've had people who had different types of seizures have immediate changes. We've had digestive problems fixed, vision issues, anything that the nervous system is involved with, the Atlas Orthogonal technique might help that. Mm-hmm. And the thought pattern on that is a structure function.
Right.
In other words, any time that you can get the nervous system balanced, you're going to make some dramatic changes in the system. And we're not saying that we have that it's a treatment for these different types of problems.
Mm-hmm.
But it's important within our philosophy to bring the body back into homeostasis. Mm-hmm. The structural portion is extremely important to help to improve the function of the body.
Now, how many people coming into the office, is their Atlas an issue, would you say?
About 80%.
And why is that? Is it just such a...
a high number?
Yeah.
You're talking about a very freely movable joint.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of trauma that can occur to the neck, even in birth. Mm-hmm. That can sometimes occur.
It can start right there.
Matter of fact, we do adjustments. We have people bring in babies who are having different types of issues that we do an Atlas adjustment on them and see.
But we don't do results. X-rays on them.
No, we don't need to do X-rays.
Uh-huh.
But it's a very, very important type of a structure to get back into place. But it is also very easy to injure.
Mm-hmm.
It's through either repetitive types of trauma or through an initial trauma. Car accidents are huge, falling. It's a very easy misalignment to occur. Mm-hmm. Because of the weakness of the structure in the neck.
And some people don't even realize if they, were you in an accident? And they can't even recall.
Of course.
If something.
A very interesting situation. I had a young gal came in with acne.
Uh huh.
And, I was checking her and I said, well, your Atlas is out.
Mm-hmm.
Because she could definitely feel the pain. She wasn't even aware of any neck pain. Mm-hmm. Wasn't a issue for her. And I said, we need to fix that. And she said, well, what does that have to do with my acne?
Uh huh.
Which is a very good question. And I said, well, I explained to her how the whole nervous system works and how much and everything can get balanced out and how that's connected to the different organ systems and how that can help with detoxification. And I said also, you'll have less stress, you'll be able to think better. So for overall health and well-being, I'd highly recommend it.
Mm-hmm.
She decided to do that, and we've got the Atlas adjusted. And she could notice an immediate change in her acne.
Hmm.
She said, how does that work?
Mm-hmm.
That is, she said that, now, is that always the answer for someone? No, you can have acne and not have your neck out of place.
Right.
But she definitely could see a difference and came back in after about a year later and said, my neck's out and my acne came back.
Mm.
And got adjusted, and she could tell an immediate difference. Now, we did other things, too, to help out.
Mm-hmm.
Detoxification of the liver, we did blood tests, balanced out her hormones, all had a huge effect on that. But nothing really would have worked unless I had done that Atlas adjustment.
Right.
It would have always been a frustration. Why? Because the body couldn't go into homeostasis.
Mm-hmm.
We had a young boy who came in, and he was 12 and still wetting his bed.
Mm-hmm.
And we were checking, and there's a lot of different types of homeopathic herbal treatments that we can do along those lines. And I said, well, first off, his neck is out of place. The Atlas is misaligned, and it would be very important to get that line back up. So we took him in there, had the adjustment. We were going to start some other treatments. And immediately that first night, he didn't wet his bed.
Wow.
Ever.
Hmm.
And they came back and said, wow, that's miraculous. Does that always work? And there's always different causes for different problems.
Right.
The way that a structure function office approaches this is to balance out the system, and the nervous system, especially the autonomic nervous system, is one of the most important things that have to be balanced out. Mm-hmm. And this is a critical aspect of all that.
Mm-hmm. So the importance of the AO and the structure function care that we do at Meridian Health and Wellness. Very good. Well, who should be checked for the AO adjustment? And we call it the AO for Atlas Orthogonal.
Sure. It makes it a little bit easier.
Right.
Because that is kind of a big word, and uh-huh. I have people, you know, I always tease people, now I'm going to make you spell it next time.
Right.
They're like, ooh.
Even
they get
for
nervous.
Our staff, yeah, we have to.
they get nervous at that point.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone should have a good physical once a year, just mm-hmm. to check and see how their entire health is. And one of the most important checks that should be done is there a misalignment in that area? That should be a basic part of everyone's check on a yearly basis to make sure that they don't have an atlas orthogonal misalignment, and if they do, to get that corrected. So everyone should be checked on that. The general population, you'll find about 80% of the people who do have that misalignment. It's not 100%. We do have people come through and really don't have an issue along those lines, which mm-hmm. is always great to see. About 80% of the people will show up that. And in independent clinical trials, that is a number that has been shown to be pretty well true.
Mm. Okay. Well, today we're talking about the Atlas Orthogonal. We'll be right back.
Listen to the Voice of Health Radio on your smartphone or tablet on all of the top radio apps available. TuneIn Radio, Stitcher, and iHeartRadio. You can find these apps and more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. This is the Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather.
Laughter is the best medicine.
So I pull up at the entrance to the emergency room. No valet parking. I mean, if that's not the biggest oversight in our solar system. If there's ever a time where you want to go, can you park this? Because I need to collapse immediately. But no, I'm circling around a parking lot. Can I park there? I think I'm going to die. I'm dying too. Okay, go ahead. Yeah, I'll go up a couple levels.
Are you frustrated by not getting to the root cause of your health issue? Are you tired of not knowing why you're always fatigued? Are you wanting to say no to toxic drugs? Have you lost hope? Are you just tired of being sick and tired? At the Prather Practice, we want you to know that we have the answers for you. We offer the alternative to the disease care model. We are the drug-free model to health and wellness. At the Prather Practice, we look for the underlying cause of your health problem and not just the symptomatology. Through thorough diagnostics, we find your individual health blueprint for your treatment. Where the disease care model is symptom-based, the structure-function model we practice gets to the root of your health issue. The Prather Practice is the most comprehensive wellness center in the Midwest. Our integrative practice offers you the most treatment options to restore your health and your hope. Learn more about the Prather Practice by calling 317-848-8048 or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. I'm Lisa Prather, and you're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice, where we get to the root cause of your health issue. This week, we're talking about the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment that, Dr. Prather, you've described as the most important thing you can do for your health. And Dr. Prather, there are, you're board certified in the Atlas Orthogonal, so there was extensive study, and I know when I talk to other chiropractors, they know how extensive, you know, this Atlas Orthogonal. And am I correct to say you're the only board-certified Atlas Orthogonist in the state of Indiana?
Yes.
Okay. Well, what is involved, yeah, the requirements for that?
There is a courses that you have to take, and then you also have to pass several tests. It usually takes about 3 years to become board certified as an Atlas Orthogonist. There are only about 45 of us in the world.
Wow.
It does take some definite time, usually some internship, to be able to get to the point that you can pass the test.
A lot of free hours, right?
Yes. Yes, so it is a very involved type of technique to learn. I've had quite a few different doctors come and approach me on learning it and finding out the requirements to be able to become board certified, decide not to do it just because of the time commitment and the study that's involved. Mm-hmm. There is a lot of mathematics, a lot of understanding to be able to, first off, read the x-rays. Mm-hmm. And then be able to translate that into the proper coordinates to be able to make the adjustment.
And it's a very specific x-ray, not only a specific adjustment,
yes,
but a specific x-ray.
It does take quite a bit to be able to get the x-ray set up. I've had a lot of x-ray techs come in who said, well, this won't be any problem. I'm an expert in taking x-rays, and mm-hmm. I go through the process and have them take some x-rays and have to correct them and say, no, this isn't quite right. And they said, wow, this is very demanding.
Uh-huh.
And not an easy type of...
Because you're getting a whole different view.
Right.
That most technicians haven't been trained in.
Actually requires specific types of instruments to be able to come up with the just to be able to set someone up correctly.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not something that we can even send out to a hospital or radiology mm-hmm. to be able to get those x-rays, just because they are so specific that people try to say that 20 times here early in the morning. It's very specific types of x-rays and not easy to accomplish. So the x-rays are very important. The examination is important. You do not want to do the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, when it's not necessary.
Right.
It is a very precise type of adjustment.
Well, let's talk about, you use an instrument. Why do you use an instrument, and what is the instrument look like?
Yes, and the instrument was Dr. Roy Sweats. He actually has a patent on that.
Uh-huh.
And the instrument is very, very specific. You need to get it down within 2 millimeters, both in the vertical resultant axis and the horizontal resultant axis. You have to have the head placement just right. You have to have the height of that. So there's a tremendous amount of evaluation that goes into the placement along those lines.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason that we use an instrument is being able to adjust the body and the hand to compensate within 2 millimeters is next to impossible.
Right.
So the hand adjustment, the way that it was done originally, was very effective, very good. I have been trained to do that particular type of adjustment, mm-hmm. but it is very difficult, and the accuracy of the instrument is definitely there. You don't have to learn all the physical requirements that are involved with it, the training that goes into it. So it helped to open up the adjustment, one, to more people doing it, but also it makes it much more scientific and reproducible.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
So, the settings that I get should be able to be done by someone else, so it's a very easily transferable type of a aspect. And then it's much better for research, and that's one of the big things that the Atlas Orthogonal Program is involved with. Matter of fact, they were written up in and actually had a presentation at the Spinal Biomechanics Conference out in Colorado, and one of the very few presentations that actually got a standing ovation.
Wow.
The top, at the time that we were doing it, Dr. Sue, who was considered as the top spinal biomechanics expert in the world, said that it was the best information dealing with spinal biomechanics and the best technique for reproducible and scientific technique within the chiropractic profession.
Wow. Yeah.
And he was very excited about it.
No wonder you wanted to be involved in that. And
yes, it was. It was
not only from personal experience, but
yes, and I want very much involved with the reproducibility, something that's very evidence based. The research that we have on that particular technique is it's overwhelming and irrefutable, and the results in any type of a test that we've done. Has shown the benefit of this particular adjustment.
Now, are there any contraindications to the AO adjustment?
That's one of the great things about the adjustment is it's a very light adjustment. One of the things that when we first started out developing the technique, we had scintigraphy radiography, which is moving X-rays, to watch the adjustment take place so that we could measure the results of the adjustment. Interestingly enough, when we first started, we had an instrument that would thrust down, but the harder we thrust, the deeper we thrust, the less movement we got.
Wow.
Reason is because the body would resist the adjustment is what we found by doing different types of tests, EMGs that the muscles would tighten up. And overcoming the body's resistance was something that we found just wasn't possible. So we came up with a percussion adjustment, much like playing croquet, where you hold one ball still, put the other ball up against it, smack the one ball, the other ball goes. That's what we're doing with the Atlas Orthogonal instrument. So there's a hammer comes down, strikes a solenoid in there. There's a compression force. That force comes out into the stylus and goes into the neck and is transferred through, and people don't feel it. As we tell them, well, the reason that we don't want you to feel it is because then your body doesn't resist it, and we're able to still put a force in, and the neck just moved like butter. The results were astounding to us. We couldn't believe the changes in the cervical spine that we got with this particular adjustment, and found that the percussion adjustment was an excellent way to do it. Also, because you are moving everything within the range of motion of the body. Some of the adjustments are based on mobilization type of philosophy. The Atlas Orthogonal is based on an alignment philosophy within chiropractic. The difference between the two, mobilization is you take the joint to its limit of motion and then take a little bit farther to try to open up the joint is the philosophy behind that. Whereas within the alignment philosophy of chiropractic, it's where you feel that something is out of place and you take it towards a within its range of motion towards a more normal. So a totally different type of philosophy than the average type of adjustment. So all the adjustments are within normal, taking the spinal column and the atlas towards the positioning that it should be. So there are really very, very, very few contraindications. I've even had people who've had fractures in the neck who, once they had healed, we had been able to do adjustments, which would be totally contraindicated in other types of conditions. People with vertebral artery syndromes, which is if you're doing a mobilization type of technique, you should never do that. With that, with those things going on, but within the Atlas Orthogonal, it's actually highly indicated. Matter of fact, that's one of the things that that it's especially good for is easing up vertebral artery syndrome. When I've had patients who, when they turn their head quickly, almost pass out. And that's due to a torsion of the vertebral artery through the atlas.
Okay.
And if you bring it back into normal, you actually relax that so you don't get those types of problems. Those are also, there's been concern about chiropractic and strokes. And oftentimes the vertebral artery syndrome can be involved in that. And the Atlas Orthogonal technique is absolutely safe in those types of situations. Matter of fact, recommended to have that done because it reduces the possibility of risk.
So that, and it doesn't hurt, right?
Oh, no. People don't even feel it.
Right. That's what you're saying.
Matter of fact, the biggest problem that I have is explaining, you know, people say, wow, I feel totally different. There's a huge change, but I didn't feel anything.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that must be fun to explain, huh?
It is. So trying to explain that is something that is the main problem with that. But people can feel the difference and the changes that occur. It's quite evident, and it's very hard to refute that.
Yeah, and what's nice is you go in and usually they have x-rays on one day. You don't adjust on that same day of x-rays.
That's because I have to figure out.
Yeah, you have to analyze them.
You have to analyze it.
Yeah,
it's very involved.
Task. Yeah. And then they come back, you review, which is nice. You review the x-rays so they can see it. And then take them in and explain how you're going to adjust them.
Truly.
Right.
Take them in, show them the instrument, explain the adjustment. After the adjustment, we recheck and check on the neurology, check on the things that should change. We see immediate changes.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, I know that day whether we accomplished what we were looking to see, and we can actually show that to the patient. The patients will feel the difference. We'll see the neurological changes that occur. It doesn't mean that all their problems are taken care of.
Right, right.
There are, as we've gone through in the 8 pillars of perfect health, there's a lot involved in mm-hmm. people's health, and there's a lot of different types of factors.
Mm-hmm.
Though this is what I believe probably the most important factor,
mm-hmm.
but it is only one factor in the total health of an individual.
Right.
We do not believe that this is a cure-all for everything.
Right.
Up next, we'll hear from a patient about the difference that the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment made in his life following a car accident. Never miss an episode of The Voice of Health so that you can stay informed and empowered about your health. Get a podcast of our show automatically delivered to you every week by signing up for our show on iTunes. You can find that link on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. And don't forget, thevoiceofhealthradio.com has complete archives of all of our past episodes with an audio library of information to help you add more life to your years and more years to your life. This is The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. The Voice of Health Wellness Tip with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice. The three tests, Dr. Prather, that you suggest everyone have every year, you know, to give a complete picture of health is the Prather Profile Blood Analysis, the GI Effects Stool Kit, and the hair analysis. And what does the hair analysis reveal about a person's health?
Well, one of the most important things that we're looking on a hair analysis is the possibility of heavy metal toxicity. That can cause a huge variety of diseases and symptoms that can actually occur. Any type of autoimmune disease could begin with a heavy metal toxicity or any type of neurological conditions, MS, ALS, a lot of those types of diseases can be kicked off by heavy metal toxicity, including a whole host of symptoms that would be hard to explain any other way. The other things that show up with the hair analysis is the balance of the minerals. It can play a huge effect on the entire system. Now, when plants actually grow, they can actually make the fatty acids, the vitamins, the amino acids, but the minerals have to come from the ground. So if the minerals aren't there, they can't make them. So the most common deficiencies that can occur in nutritional health of an individual is mineral deficiencies or mineral imbalances. And the hair analysis is the best way to actually show up those changes that can occur.
Well, how does the hair analysis help find the root cause of health issues? And no pun intended there.
When you're actually trying to discover what's going on in an individual, so many things can actually result with a mineral imbalance or a heavy metal toxicity that behooves us to actually do that particular test. And that's one reason that I recommend it be done at least once a year. And if there's any type of important type of disease process going on or unexplained symptoms, checking on the hair analysis really can show a tremendous amount and cause reveal the underlying problem.
Schedule your appointment at the Prather Practice, 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. The Prather Practice, restoring hope. You're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice, where our mission is restoring hope to our patients. We're talking this week about the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, and we're joined by Trevor, a patient here at the Prather Practice, to share his story.
I was rear-ended in an automobile accident in Bloomington on the 6th of August. So I had a lot of pain up and down my spine, my neck, a lot of issues with mobility, and pretty much the general whiplash symptoms. And in terms of what I received here, chiropractic adjustments, some physical rehab to work on strengthening and stretching the muscle tissue. I received some massage and some auricular adjustments, which is kind of like acupuncture.
Mm-hmm. Great. What kind of symptoms after your accident, you know, you mentioned whiplash, what kind of symptoms were you having?
Well, I was, in terms of symptoms, I was having a lot of pain, throughout, over most of my body, but the majority of the pain was, in my neck area and my low back, and that's where I experienced most of the pain.
Was it affecting you functionally, your daily life?
Yes, I go through two full-time school programs, and it was difficult to perform the duties that I needed to in those school programs. And sleep was also an issue I was having. I was waking up in the evenings and having trouble getting comfortable because I couldn't really find a position to lay in that wasn't painful.
So, in your experience, you said the services you received, chiropractic adjustments, you also had rehabilitation and some massage and auricular therapy. What did you experience with those treatments?
Well, first and foremost, after the initial x-rays and evaluation, the first procedure that was performed was an Atlas adjustment, which was something I was not familiar with at the time, but it turned out that one particular procedure changed everything. I felt 100% better following that particular procedure. And then the chiropractic adjustments, the rehab, the auricular, and the massage kind of got me from that feeling good place to a place of normalcy, so where I was used to feeling like that. I still had some pain in the beginning, but it was considerably less. And as we went through the treatment, just got less and less, and I was able to deal with it in the right way.
Great. So you're going to be discharged from care here real soon. We're going to miss you around here. That's what happens. But what have, you know, since these treatments, what have you experienced and what are you looking forward to from the treatments?
Well, coming in with a lot of pain, from that first adjustment on, reduction in pain has been the number one thing. The rehab that I received gave me a lot of strength-building exercises to keep me healthy and keep me from needing adjustments constantly. I know a lot of practices you need adjustments weekly for the next, you know, 6, 7, 8. 12 months, but we got to a place where I could kind of deal with it. And one thing that I was really concerned about was I don't take any sort of prescription medication, and Dr. Prather was adamant about seeing that through for me and being able to manage pain without medication. So that's kind of what I'm looking forward to, is being able to continue strengthening my back and my neck and deal with pain without medication. That's been really important to me.
If someone's listening and considering treatment here at Meridian Health and Wellness, what would you tell them?
I would say to absolutely come and to get evaluated, find out what options that they have available for you, and just come try to find a better way to deal with pain or to just start to feel better, because traditional medicine in the medical doctor hospital sense is not something that I particularly find appealing, but the practices here at Prather Wellness has just been amazing for me as a holistic type person.
Well, thank you, Trevor, sharing that. I know someone that's listening out there, it will definitely help them. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
So, Dr. Prather, in Trevor's case, what did you find on exam that you knew that his atlas was misaligned?
There were neurological signs down into his arms. There was weakness in the hands. As we did tracing on the nerves coming down from his neck, both the ulnar and radial nerve were impinged. He also had some upper motor neuron signs and then had a leg length discrepancy, which is usually signs that the spinal cord is being impinged. Along with that, whenever I would palpate the exits of his nervous and up in his neck, he would make awful faces. And he was suffering from a lot of neck pain, headaches, all the symptoms that go along with that. So,
and yeah. I think he didn't come in right away after his accident. He didn't hear about us till, right, I think, 4 months down the road.
Yeah, he had tried other different types of treatments, physical therapy, things like that. So when we got him in there, he really hadn't had any relief and had been recommended to come in to see us. As we were examining, we showed, his need for it. It was very obvious that he needed that corrected. We took him into the adjustment, did the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, got him up, and immediately all of his pain was gone.
Mm-hmm.
All of his neurological signs were gone, which is a very common type of finding that we have with the program.
Right.
So
he received other therapies that were very helpful, but he said the Atlas Orthogonal is what relieved the
absolutely
pain.
Well, the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, yeah, it certainly isn't by at all the only thing that we do in
right,
our office.
The mm-hmm.
There are most people don't need an Atlas Orthogonal very often.
Mm-hmm. Adjustment.
That mm-hmm. that particular adjustment. Because it's something that holds, it's an immediate type of change, and it's not something that we usually have to repeat on a most people hold it at least a year.
Mm-hmm. Now you're adjusting
longer.
The other areas of the spine, like for Trevor, but he hasn't had to have his atlas adjusted.
Correct.
Again.
There are manipulations for the rest of the spine. We adjust every bone in the entire body.
Mm-hmm.
It's the atlas is something that we need to have hold. The longer we can hold, that's why we do exercises. That's why we do a lot of the treatments, and that's also why we do a lot of the other adjustments.
Mm-hmm.
To help that to stabilize and hold its, the longer it holds, the more healing occurs.
Now, what if Trevor wouldn't have gotten that help? He had a car accident, and many people get in car accidents and don't get the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment, unfortunately.
Sure.
What can happen?
Well, the body tries to compensate. There's a lot of shifting that occurs. There's shifting in the rest of the spine to try to take off pressure
mm-hmm.
in the atlas area because it wants to preserve the integrity of that area. So the body learns to compensate. It also causes some degeneration.
Mm-hmm.
There is the ligaments will actually calcify to try to reduce the motion in that area so that there isn't as much irritation of the nervous system. So there's a tremendous amount of degeneration that occurs mm-hmm. because of that.
Mm-hmm.
So the sooner that we can get those fixed, the quicker that the less degeneration actually occurs. Matter of fact, I can usually tell just by looking at the x-rays about when that particular accident occurred, how
wow.
long ago.
Uh-huh.
said, wow, you had some type of an injury about 18 years ago or 20 years ago, 25, 5 years ago, mm-hmm. 3 years ago, because I can tell by the changes that have occurred in the cervical spine due to the misalignment in the atlas. Mm. That is something that is evident on the x-rays, and usually we're quite dead on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But, you know, it was a real positive experience for Trevor, and really helped his, you know, healing, and you see that often.
Yes, and you really don't heal unless you have that fixed. There mm-hmm. isn't a resolving of the issue. There's a compensation that the body does because the body is miraculous on how it works with things, but if you don't have that atlas back into a proper type of positioning, there's going to be consequences to that, and there will be changes that can become permanent.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dr. Prather, you have a few seconds. What would you like to conclude with on the Atlas Orthogonal Adjustment?
Definitely that should be a part of everyone's yearly exam. If someone has some unresolved types of health issues, having the atlas checked to make sure that that's functioning properly would be an important part of the overall evaluations of someone's condition.
Okay. Well, thank you, Dr. Prather, as always. We're out of time for this week.
The Prather Practice is located at 8902 North Meridian Street on the north side of Indianapolis, just south of the I-465 loop. If we can help you to achieve better health, we'd love to hear from you. Connect with our office at 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Join us again here next week or anytime on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com for The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather.